स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ दीपक एंड वेलकम टू माई चैनल दीपक बायोलॉजी क्लासेज। तो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप दैट यू पीपल आर डूइंग फाइन। सो फ्रेंड, टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द HPLC मीन्स हाई परफॉर्मेंस लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। तो बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग इन टू दैट, लेट अस रिमाइंड अवर लास्ट लेक्चर। तो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वॉट वी स्टडीड अबाउट द क्रोमेटोग्राफी, इट्स प्रिंसिपल एंड ऑल्सो टाइप्स, लाइक इट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी, लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी एंड सुपर क्रिटिकल फ्लूइड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। एंड देन दिस गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी, इट इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू टाइप्स, दैट इज गैस सॉलिड क्रोमेटोग्राफी एंड गैस लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। एंड द लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी विच इज डिवाइडेड इंटू अदर्स क्रोमेटोग्राफी टाइप्स लाइक द HPLC, साइज एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी, आयन एक्सचेंज क्रोमेटोग्राफी, पेपर क्रोमेटोग्राफी, थिन लेयर क्रोमेटोग्राफी, साइज एक्सक्लूजन क्रोमेटोग्राफी। सो टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द HPLC। ओके, तो आज हम क्या डिस्कस करेंगे? HPLC। सो HPLC क्या है? इट्स अ हाई परफॉर्मेंस लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। ओके, और हम इसे दूसरी क्या इसका नाम हो सकता है? तो दूसरा इसका नाम हो सकता है हाई प्रेशर लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी। ओके, सो वी कैन गिव HPLC टू नेम, इट्स अ हाई परफॉर्मेंस लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी आल्सो, एंड वी कैन से हाई प्रेशर लिक्विड क्रोमेटोग्राफी आल्सो। So why we call this HPLC a high performance liquid chromatography or a high pressure liquid chromatography? So if we talk about the high pressure, so in case of HPLC, the solvent moves with a very high pressure. So whatever the solvent is present, then it moves with a very high pressure. So for that a pump is required. Okay, so a pump is present in the HPLC instrumentation. So this pump, what it did, it allow the solvent to move with a very high pressure. Because of that, this is called the high pressure liquid chromatography. So a pump has been installed in the instrumentation so that the solvent, whatever the solvent is present in the mobile phase, it moves with a very high pressure. Okay, now if we talk about the high performance liquid chromatography, so why it is called the high performance? Because it is having a very good ability to differentiate between the various components which is present in the mixture. So इसका जो बात करें तो HPLC की sensitivity बहुत ही अच्छी है. Okay, so it is having a good sensitivity or we can say the resolution. Okay, so this HPLC having a very good sensitivity or we can say the resolution. Okay, for example, if we take a mixture of various components. Okay, suppose it's a mixture of various substances. Okay, so this is a mixture of various substances. So its ability or its sensitivity is very good that it can differentiate between the various components which is present in the mixture. Okay, so then it has the ability to differentiate various components. So this ability of HPLC is very good, or we can say its resolution is good, or the its sensitivity is very good that it can differentiate the various components from the mixture. So because of that, it is called the high performance liquid chromatography. Okay, so now this HPLC, it is of liquid chromatography. Okay, so as I mentioned in my last video that this HPLC, it's a part of liquid chromatography type. So in HPLC, whatever the component, or we can say whatever the mixture of the substances which we want to separate, it dissolved in the liquid form. Okay, so that's why it is a type of liquid chromatography. Okay, now the question comes that what is the basis, okay, on what basis the molecules, or we can say the components, get separated by using this HPLC. Okay, so So the component which are present in the mixture, they separate on the basis of polarity. On the basis of polarity. Okay, means it may be hydrophobic or hydrophilic. Okay, so whatever the components which are present on the mixture, it may be hydrophobic or it may be hydrophilic, or we can say it can be both. Okay, hydrophobic means they are water heater, water heaters, or we can say they are non-polar. Okay, if you talk about the hydrophilic, they are water lovers and they are polar in nature. Okay, so whatever the components, or we can say the substances which is present in the mixture, it may be of two types, the hydrophobic or the hydrophilic, or we can say the both, means both type of components can be present in the mixture which we want to separate. So this is the basic about the HPLC. Now the question comes, on what basis and what is the principle behind this HPLC. So as we know that in HPLC two types of phases has been used. The first one is stationary phase, okay, and the another one is mobile phase. So this is a mobile phase. Okay, so when there is interaction between the stationary phase and the mobile phase takes place, then the components of the mixture get separated from each other. So this interaction is very important, and because of this interaction between the mobile phase and the stationary phase, various components, they get separated from each other. Okay, so this HPLC, it is of two types normally. The first one is normal phase HPLC and the another is reverse phase HPLC. So we will discuss that. HPLC, it is of two types. Broadly, we divide into two types. The first one is normal phase HPLC, and the second one is reverse phase HPLC. Okay, so HPLC broadly divided into two types. The first is normal phase. Normal phase HPLC and the second one is reverse phase HPLC. So the question comes, sir, what are the mobile phases and stationary phase required for normal phase HPLC and the reverse phase HPLC? So if we talk about in the normal phase HPLC, so mobile phase and the stationary phase. So in case of normal phase HPLC, the mobile phase, it is non-polar in nature. Non-polar. So it is hydrophobic. And stationary phase, it will be a polar. Means hydrophilic. Okay. So in case of normal phase HPLC, the mobile phase is non-polar and means it means hydrophobic, means it is having the water heating properties. On the other hand, if you talk about the stationary phase, so in the case of a stationary phase, okay, so in the stationary phase, it is polar in nature. Okay, means it is having the hydrophilic property. Okay, or we can say it is having a water loving in nature. Okay, so if we talk about the reverse phase SPLC, so in reverse phase SPLC, it is just opposite of that of normal phase SPLC. Okay, so here in the mobile phase, it will be a polar and it is hydrophilic in nature. Hydrophilic. On the other hand, stationary phase, it will be a non-polar. Means hydrophobic. So, because of the interaction between the mobile phase and the stationary phase, the components which are present in the mixture, they get separated from each other. Okay, so now we will talk about the normal phase SPLC. Okay, so before going to normal phase SPLC, let's see the instrumentation. Okay, and what are the components which are attached to the SPLC. Okay, so the first one is, will be the solvent. Okay, so in that flask, solvent will be present. So whatever the mobile phase which we want to use, that will be present. After that, it is connected to a pump, because that pump, let me write. So it will be a solvent. After that, this solvent, it is connected with the pump. Okay, so there is a pump. So what is the function of this pump? This pump, it generate a very high pressure of approximately 400 atm. यानी कि 400 एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर का जो है ये पंप प्रेशर क्रिएट करता है सॉल्वेंट को एक्सट्रैक्ट करने के लिए, यानी सॉल्वेंट को मूव करने के लिए. आफ्टर दैट दिस पंप इट इज कनेक्टेड विद द एचपीएलसी कॉलम. एचपीएलसी कॉलम, ओके. एंड इन बिटवीन दिस इट इज अ सैंपल, बिकॉज सॉल्वेंट इज मूविंग थ्रू दिस पंप एंड देन इट मूव्स थ्रू द कॉलम. So in between we have to inject our sample. So this is a sample and this is an injector. And this point is an inlet point. Okay, through this point we can inject our sample. After that, this is connected to the SPLC column. So here the stationary phase comes. Means the molecules which are stationary in nature, it is very tightly paired. Okay, after that, this HPLC column, it is connected with the detector. Detector detect the signals, okay, or we can say it detect the components, and then this detector, it send the signal to the system. And along with that, there is a other outlet where the collecting tube is present. Collecting tube. Where the sample gets collected. Okay, so this is a basic instrumentation, or we can say the components of the HPLC. Okay, so let's start about the normal phase HPLC and how it works. So first of all, what we did, सबसे पहले हम लोग क्या करेंगे, जो normal solvent है, हम कह सकते हैं जो buffer है, उसे हम लोग क्या करेंगे, pass करेंगे इस HPLC से. Okay, so जैसे ही buffer को हम लोग pass करेंगे, तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, जो ये जो बफर है, इट विल पास थ्रू द स्टेशनरी कॉलम, और वी कैन से एसपीएलसी कॉलम, एंड दैट बफर इज डिटेक्टेड बाय द डिटेक्टर. एंड देन व्हाट वी विल सी, वी विल सी अ फ्लैट लाइन ऑफ दैट बफर. दिस फ्लैट लाइन इज बेस लाइन. ओके, अंडरस्टूड. व्हाई वी रन द बेस लाइन, सो दैट आवर जो कॉलम है, जो स्पेस कॉलम है, इट गेट इक्विलिब्रेट. ओके, एंड देन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इक्विलिब्रेशन, अवर बफर इट विल मूव थ्रू दिस एचपीएलसी कॉलम, एंड देन इट डिटेक्टेड बाय द डिटेक्टर, एंड देन इट गिव अ फ्लैट लाइन. सो दिस इज अ बेस लाइन, मींस अब जो एचपीएलसी कॉलम है, इट इज रेडी फॉर प्यूरिफिकेशन. ओके, सो अब क्या करते हैं, अब हम लोग जैसे नॉर्मल फेज एचपीएलसी में मोबाइल फेज क्या यूज करते हैं, इट इज नॉन पोलर इन नेचर. तो हियर this solvent, it include mixture of hexane plus isopropanol or we can say chloroform. ओके सो ये सॉल्वेंट है या मोबाइल फेज है, इसे हम मोबाइल फेज भी बोल सकते हैं, मोबाइल फेज. ओके सो दिस मिक्सचर इट कंटेन्स द मिक्सचर ऑफ हेक्सेन प्लस आइसोप्रोपेनॉल और द क्लोरोफॉर्म. तो दिस इज द मोबाइल फेज फॉर नॉर्मल फेज एचपीएलसी. ओके अंडरस्टूड ना. सो सबसे पहले हमने क्या किया, जो बफर है उसे रन किया कॉलम के थ्रू, और उस बफर को जो डिटेक्टर ने डिटेक्ट किया, एंड देन इट गिव अ फ्लैट लाइन, मींस हमारा जो कॉलम है नाउ इट इज रेडी फॉर प्यूरिफिकेशन. ओके आफ्टर दैट वी स्टार्टेड अवर नॉर्मल फेज एचपीएलसी. तो फॉर नॉर्मल फेज एचपीएलसी द मोबाइल फेज इज नॉन पोलर, मींस इट इज हाइड्रोफोबिक इन नेचर. सो वी हैव टेकन मिक्सचर ऑफ हेक्सेन प्लस आइसोप्रोपेनॉल और वी कैन यूज द क्लोरोफॉर्म ऑल्सो. तो दिस विल बी अवर मोबाइल फेज. सो आफ्टर दैट दिस मोबाइल फेज द सॉल्वेंट स्टार्ट मूविंग विद अ वेरी हाई प्रेशर विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पंप. So this pump it generate almost 400 atmospheric pressure. Okay, with the help of this pump it generate pressure and then this solvent start moving. So now comes here sample. So now the question comes ki what type of sample we can use. So we can use drugs also. Along with that we can use some plant extract or we can use some plant extract decks, okay, or we can use some lipids also, etc. So these are some samples which we can use to separate the components from the mixture. Okay, so after injecting the sample, so with the help of injector, we will inject the sample and then this sample will get mixed up with the solvent and then it passed through the HPLC column. Okay, so in case of HPLC column, this is our mobile phase. Now here the stationary phase comes. Okay, so this is a stationary phase. And this stationary phase, it is polar in nature. Normally, jo stationary phase hai, suppose this is a stationary phase. Suppose it is polar in nature. Okay, so this stationary phase it is made of silica. Okay, तो stationary phase किसका बना हुआ होता है? Silica का बना होता है. ठीक है? अब क्या हुआ कि जो solvent है, along with sample, it started moving and then it reached to the HPLC column. Okay, अब sample में क्या होता है? Two types of molecules are present. Okay, तो sample is having two types of molecules. That is hydrophobic or hydrophilic. Okay, तो ये sample जो वो inject कर रहे हैं, इस sample में hydrophobic molecules भी हो सकते हैं या components हो सकते हैं और the hydrophilic components भी हो सकते हैं. ठीक है? अब हमारा जो solvent है, हम लोग कहते हैं तो mobile phase है, it is non-polar in nature. Okay, and this stationary phase it is hydrophilic. Okay, means it is polar in nature. We can write polar also. Okay, so अब जो sample में जो भी hydrophobic component होंगे, ठीक है? तो ये hydrophobic component जो होंगे, it will elute first. Okay, जो hydrophobic component होंगे, it will elute first. While the hydrophilic component, it will get struck. Or we can say it will get adsorbed on the surface of stationary phase. Why? Because this stationary phase is polar in nature, so hydrophilic molecule it will make some bond. Okay, this hydrophilic molecule it will make bond. That bond maybe be hydrogen bond, or we can say they will get attached with each other on the basis of dipole-dipole interaction. Okay, so these hydrophilic molecule they will get attached or adsorbed on the surface of stationary phase because they are of same nature, means their polarity is same. This stationary phase is also in polar in nature and the hydrophilic molecule they are also in same in nature. Okay, so the hydrophobic molecule they will elute first. So let us see, suppose this is the hydrophobic molecule and the second one and the second one is this one. Okay, so this black one, if you talk, you know, it is more hydrophobic in nature, means it is highly hydrophobic, and the red one, it is less hydrophobic. Okay, so this black one, it will elute fast. ठीक है, अब ये जो ब्लैक वन मॉलिक्यूल है या ब्लैक कंपोनेंट, इट विल इल्यूट एंड इट विल गेट डिटेक्टेड एंड देन वी विल गेट अ पीक. ओके, आफ्टर दैट, सॉरी ब्लैक, ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ हाई हाइड्रोफोबिक इन नेचर दिस मॉलिक्यूल विल elute first and then it will be detected by the detector, and then it detector it send a signal to the system, and then we will get this type of peak. Okay, so after that, the less hydrophobic molecule, that is red one, it will pass, then it will again detected by the detector, and then it will send a signal to the system, then we will get another peak. Okay, so here we got two peak. So this black one, because of this, it is high hydrophobic in nature, then it will elute first and then it will give a peak. Okay, after that, the less hydrophobic molecule, that is red one, it will elute and then it will detect by detector, and then it will give the another peak. Okay, so this is the basic principle behind this. Okay, after that, the hydrophilic molecules, because of same nature, same polarity, it will get adsorbed on the surface, and these molecules, these hydrophilic molecules, they move very slowly each other, because dono kya hai, same nature ke hai, polarity same hai, isliye wo kya honge, bahut hi slowly kya honge, move karenge. Okay, so ye ek tha principle behind the normal phase SPLC and how this normal phase SPLC work. So here one terms comes, that is isocretic. Isocretic illusion. Okay, so in isocretic illusion, what is the matlab means? So in isocretic illusion, we don't change the mobile phase components. Okay, so if suppose there is a mixture of hexane and isopropanol or a chloroform is there, so we can't change. We don't change the mobile phase composition. So for separating the component, so this type of illusion is called the isocretic illusion, means the mobile phase composition remains constant throughout the separation procedure. Okay, so this is the basis of the normal phase SPLC. And one more thing, whatever the graph we generate, it is of retention time. So in the x axis, retention time will be there, and in the y axis, signal will be there. Okay, so now the question comes, ki how can we determine the concentration of that component? Okay, so that how we can do, we can measure the this peak area. Okay, so with measuring the peak area, we can determine that what is the concentration of that specific component which is present in the mixture. So with the help of this peak area, we can determine the component, or we can say the concentration of the component in the mixture. Okay, so this is the normal phase SPLC. Okay, so now we will discuss about the reverse phase SPLC. Okay, so mostly nowadays people, or we can say the researcher, they are mostly dependent on the reverse phase SPLC. Okay, so we will discuss about the reverse phase SPLC. So here what we have to change, we have to change the mobile phase and the stationary phase. So here we will change the mobile phase along with that stationary phase. So in reverse phase SPLC, all the things will be the same. Only what we have to change, we have to change the mobile phase or stationary phase. So here in the mobile phase, what component, what solution we can use? So here we will use 90% H2O plus 10% acetonitrile, or we can use methanol also. Okay, So this is your mobile page. Okay, and then in stationary phase, what will you use? This is a stationary phase. Okay, so here what we'll use? We will use silica, but it will be a modified. Okay, so how we can be modify the silica? So we will add a C18 carbon chain there. Okay, so here what silica we use? So silica with C18 carbon chain. So this silica with carbon 18 chain we can use at a stationary phase. Okay, so in case of mobile phase, as you see that in mobile phase it is polar. Okay, so it is polar, it will be a polar in nature, polar. Okay, and the stationary phase it will be a hydrophobic, yeah, non-polar, non-polar or the hydrophobic. Okay, so the instrumentation is same, everything is same, only what we have changed here the mobile phase and the stationary phase. Like in normal phase SPLC, mobile phase are non-polar and the stationary phase were polar, and in case of reverse phase SPLC we just reversed it. So mobile phase is polar, that is hydrophilic, and the stationary phase it is non-polar, means hydrophobic. Okay, so now here there is a bead of silica, okay, some solid bead of silica is there. Okay, and this silica with C18, it is hydrophobic in nature. Okay, so again the same process and the principle is same. Okay, then again there is a solvent which consists of mobile phase, then it attaches to the pump and then it attaches to the SPLC column. In this the solvent moves with a very high speed, that's why the SPLC or column hota hai, ye bana hota hai stainless steel ka. Okay, so SPLC column it is made up of stainless steel because a very high pressure is there inside the HPLC column. Because of that, it should be made of some stainless steel which is very tough. Okay, and these silica C18 particles they are packed very tightly so that the purification should be very good. Okay, so now what happened here 90% water and the 10% H2Nitrile or the methanol will be taken at the mobile phase, and it is polar in nature. So mobile phase kya ho gayi? It is polar. While the stationary phase it conserves silica with C18 carbon. Okay, it is a modified version of silica, and then it is non-polar and hydrophobic. So again, sample mein kya hua? It consists of two types of molecules, hydrophobic also and the hydrophilic also. Okay, so again, with the help of pump, it generates pressure and then it allows the solvent to move with a very high pressure. So again, here we will inject the sample, then it moves and then it moves through the column, HPLC column, along with the solvent. So now here only the reverse will happen. Okay, suppose it is hydrophobic. So hydrophobic molecules, they will get interact with these hydrophobic molecules with some bonds. Okay, so ab kya hoga? Hydrophobic molecule aur jo hydrophobic molecule honge wo aapas mein interact karenge. Theek hai, ab bache hue jo hydrophilic molecule hai, these along with solvent they will elute first. Okay, so for example, again if we take black one, it is more hydrophilic in nature, and then this blue one, it is less hydrophilic, but it is still hydrophilic. So what happened? This hydrophilic molecule, it will elute first. Okay, so this hydrophilic molecule, it will elute first because it don't have any interaction with the hydrophobic stationary phase. Okay, so it will elute first, and then again it is detected by the detector, and this detector it will send the signal to the system. Okay, then what we will see? BBC या PE. Okay, so this is the first peak of first hydrophilic molecule which elute first. After that, the second hydrophilic molecule which is less hydrophilic. So what is come? It will come and then it will elute. Okay, so again it will be this graph will be based on retention time, and the signal. Or we can say concentration also. Okay, so अब क्या हुआ कि stationary phase क्या है? ये hydrophobic है, ठीक है? आप जो sample hydrophobic होंगे, वो आपस में interact करेंगे, ठीक है? Interact करेंगे और जो molecules हैं, it will get adsorbed on the surface of this solid stationary bead. Okay, अब hydrophilic molecules क्या हैं? ये जो है hydrophobic molecules क्या? बिल्कुल भी interact नहीं करेंगे, ठीक है? तो this hydrophilic molecule they don't interact with the hydrophobic molecules, then these hydrophilic molecule it mixed with the solvent and then it will elute first. So the black one is more hydrophilic, okay, so it will elute first and then it give a peak of that component, and then the blue one, it is less hydrophilic but still it is hydrophilic, then it will elute and it will be detected by the detector, and then this detector it will send the signal to the system and then it will elute second. Okay, so like that we will get a peak. So this peak it will be a on x-axis retention time and the signal strength. Now the question comes, what is retention time? Okay, so retention time means how long your analyte or the component stuck, or we can say stay in the HPLC column. So that is called the retention time. Means kitne time tak aapka jo analyte hai ya elute hai wo kitne टाइम तक जो एनालाइट या कंपोनेंट है वो इस एचपीएलसी कॉलम में रहा, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड द रिटेंशन टाइम. अगेन क्या होगा, वी कैन कैलकुलेट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ दीज कंपोनेंट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस पीक. ओके, सो द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ दिस पीक इज कॉल्ड द क्रोमेटोग्राम. ओके, तो अरेंजमेंट ऑफ दीज पीक्स ऑन द ग्राफ इज कॉल्ड द क्रोमेटोग्राम. Okay, so with the help of this peak area, we can calculate that what is the concentration of that specific component in the mixture. Okay, so this is the principle behind the reverse phase HPLC. So what we did, we just reverse the phases, mobile phase and the stationary phase, and then here in this case, the hydrophilic molecule, it elutes first. Okay, because this hydrophilic molecule don't have any interaction with the hydrophobic molecule. Okay, while the hydrophobic molecule, it will be having some interaction with the hydrophobic molecule because of the same polarity. So they will elute late. So this type of reverse phase HPLC we also called as concentration gradient. Concentration gradient. So why we call it concentration gradient? So here the hydrophobic molecules is still there in the HPLC column. Okay, क्योंकि hydrophilic molecule है, वो क्या है, वो solvent के साथ तो निकल गए, क्योंकि solvent की polarity polar था और जो sample था वो भी hydrophilic या polar था, तो solvent के साथ क्या हुआ, जो hydrophilic नीचे के जो sample थे components से वो तो निकल गए, लेकिन जो hydrophobic molecules हैं, they are still stick in these components, in these solid silica bead. जो hydrophobic molecule हैं, it is still present in the silica gel solid bead. Okay. So, अब क्या होगा, अब हम लोग क्या करेंगे, इसकी जो पोलैरिटी है उसे रिवर्स कर देंगे, ठीक है? नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल चेंज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. तो हियर 10% H2O एंड 90% एस्ट्रोनाइट्राइल. ओके, सो इफ यू विल डू द जस्ट द रिवर्स, ओके, तो इट विल बिकम नॉन पोलर. तो इट विल बिकम नॉन पोलर. अब क्या होगा, जो हाइड्रोफोबिक मॉलिक्यूल है जो इस स्टेशनरी फेज में डिफ्यूज है या स्टेट है, अब क्या होगा, जो नॉन पोलर सॉल्वेंट है, सॉल्वेंट क्या है, उसकी पोलैरिटी चेंज हो गई, ठीक है? पोलैरिटी चेंज होने की वजह से क्या हुआ, अब जो सॉल्वेंट है मोबाइल फेज है, इट इज नॉन पोलर इन नेचर. अब ये क्या होगा, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पंप, दिस सॉल्वेंट मूव्स विद अ वेरी हाई स्पीड एंड देन अलोंग विद दिस हाइड्रोफोबिक मॉलिक्यूल, क्योंकि जो मोबाइल फेज है वो भी हाइड्रोफोबिक होगी, तो अलोंग विद दैट दीज रिमेनिंग हाइड्रोफोबिक मॉलिक्यूल्स विल आल्सो एलूड वन बाय वन. And then it will be detected by the detector, and then we will again get the peak of those hydrophobic molecules also. Okay, with that also we can again calculate the concentration of those hydrophobic molecules or the component on the basis of this peak, or we can say on the basis of the area of the peak. So this is all about the HPLC and how this HPLC works and what are the mobile and stationary phase, because this mobile and stationary phase, they are very important for separating any component. So whatever the components which are present in the mixer, they separate only on the interaction between the mobile phase and the stationary phase. Okay, so this is all about HPLC. Now we'll talk about the applications of HPLC. Okay, so applications of HPLC. So इसके applications क्या क्या हो सकते हैं? If we talk about the applications, so we can use this HPLC in the pharmaceutical chemistry. Pharmaceutical industry. Along with that, we can use it in the clinical sciences also. Clinical sciences, forensic sciences, analytical chemistry, food technology, etc. So there are the n number of applications of this HPLC. Like we can use this HPLC in the pharmaceutical industry, clinical sciences, forensic sciences, analytical chemistry, or we can say in food technology. So pharmaceutical industry में कैसे use कर सकते हैं? तो in the pharmaceutical industry we can separate and analyze the non-volatile components. Okay, yeah, we can say non-volatile compounds. Okay, so in pharmaceutical industry, along with that, we can use to quantify or the qualify the various components which are present on the various products. Like if you talk about the aspirin or paracetamol, so there if you want to see like what are the quality and the quantitative, or we can say what are the components which are present in those specific products, so that we can do with the help of HPLC. Along with that we can use it in the forensic science also. So in forensic science also कैसे कि suppose कहीं अगर कोई crime होता है तो वहाँ पे अगर किसी का murder हो जाता है तो उसके कुछ blood stain या कुछ उसके बॉडी में ब्लड ब्लड रह जाता है, तो उन ब्लड स्टेन को हम लोग देख सकते हैं कि उसमें कौन कौन से कंपोनेंट प्रेजेंट हैं, ठीक है, तो उसमें फॉरेंसिक साइंस में यूज हो सकता है. फूड टेक्नोलॉजी में कैसे यूज हो सकता है कि हम लोग जो देख सकते हैं कि सपोज किस कंपनी ने कौन सा जो फूड बनाया है उसमें प्रोडक्ट बनाया, उस प्रोडक्ट में कौन कौन से कंपोनेंट्स हैं, ठीक है, और उन कंपोनेंट्स को हम लोग एनालाइज कर सकते हैं कि वो कंपोनेंट्स वेदर इट इज बैड और नॉट बैड. ओके, तो इन फूड टेक्नोलॉजी में मोस्टली दिस HPLC वी आर यूजिंग इन अवर like labs also for separating the support lipids content from the sample, or we can say some other component from the plant extract, or we can also separate the carotenoids also. So this HPLC, this reverse phase HPLC, it is having a n numbers of applications. Okay, so mostly in the everywhere, mostly 80% people, they are using the reverse phase HPLC. So this is all about the HPLC, its types, its principles and also the application. So I hope you people कि आपको ये जो video है ये अच्छा लगा होगा. If you like the video, then share it, and if you are new to my channel, so please subscribe it. Thank you.